When you go to a club or a party in those days, it's something that you could talk about like days and weeks after. You see a girl used to dress, you know, like this big afro hair do, and short miniskirts or hot pants and so on. And then they would sort of put their handbag in the middle of the dance floor and dance around it. Now, if you're going out and you want to be friendly with those girls, you would sort of look and see, you know, a couple of dances, if they're still dancing on their own, you know, that they haven't got any escort, a male escort or anything. So you and your mate, I mean, you and your mate used to, like, dress alike, you know, afro hairdo or a skipper haircut and nice frilly shirt. If you didn't have a frilly shirt, you could buy a frill cut buttonholes in and pin it onto your shirt. Nice tight flare bell bottoms, trousers with a split at the side, you know, up to the high heel shoes and so on. And you'd go on the dance floor, and when you notice these girls to attract their attention, you'd go and you'd put your pretty dance down, the best dance you can find. Oh, I tell you, it could be embarrassing. Having finished your nice dance, the next record comes around and you ask the young lady for a dance, she'll look at you from head to toe and say, mm-mm.
Okay, this is the infamous shell club where, as kids, me, Ali, Astro World and that used to hang around. It's in the back of a churchyard, actually, and this is where the majority of records, which are on our Labour of Love 1 and 2, happened. This is where I actually listened to Singer Man and things like that.
Singer Man, sing me a song. Singer Man, sing me a song.
I'm telling you, you know, I'm like, this is it. This is like the ultimate place, you know what I mean?
I mean, you could either hang around the pubs up in town, which we were too young to get into, so therefore we had to come here to listen to our favourite music, because there wasn't many clubs in Birmingham at the time that would play.
Yeah, but it's like places like this is like where you met your friends, and like, you know, the kids that you met as, you know, while we was all babies, you know, and then become our mates now. You know, people who we've met since then, they haven't really got such a strong standing with you as kids who used to come down here.
Forget that. Remember, we used to come here and we learned to dance. Oh, the grind and the shuffle and the scanner
the
and things like that.
Girls for the first time, you know, yeah.
This is where dirty dancing was, in fact, invented.
It was something we all had in common. We all loved reggae music, apart from other types of music as well. We all loved reggae music, and that was one of the things that drew us all together.
Once you go into a club and you hear these kind of records playing, then you don't want to leave the dance floor. You just want to dance until the club's finished, you know? And that's what it's all about, really, having a good time. If you work hard in the week, you put on your best clothes, go out Saturday night, and have a good dance.
I just have a listen. I know it's rough, but we'll forget it. Right? That's the arrangement, though. It works, doesn't it?
Yeah, sounds great.
When all the vocals are down and everything, your percussion lines are out.
Hey, man, those big chords.
Yeah, turn it up for us.
Those big chords, they sound wicked as well.
I've got a track there for sure. He's over there. It's a live one.
Love with me, baby. Laying on my tub. Usually we do everything from the start to the finish, including mixing and producing. We usually do everything. This time we've decided to farm the mixing out to our engineer, Jerry Parchment, and Bertie. And then I saw Bertie, and a few of us saw Bertie at Dennis Brown concerts and mixing the sound for Frankie Paul and a few other reggae artists. And, in a live situation, he was great, you know. And so we thought, give him a try.
Again.
Lower than this.
All right, same thing with that.
Lower.
That's all right, Jerry. That could tone down enough.
All right, then. Where are you going to mix it with?
Tone it down. Tone it down not so brawly bright.
Brawly bright?
Brawly bright. Make it a more duller.
I'll turn the brawly bright
button. Yeah.
This is the first time that they invite me to really twiddle some knobs and put some reggae in the music. Reggae is a feel, it's got category. They've categorized the English soft music, lovers rock. The category, the burning spear type sounds, roots, and then the category, the digital stuff, them as dancehall material, which this stuff has got a bit of everything. It's got the sound in the modern sound of the dancehall instrument. It's got the roots feel, which the band had from time, and it's got that lovers rock on English feel on top of it also.